Nancy Liu's speech is entitled The Interview. She is the Toastmistress with a heart of gold, will be telling us about The Interview. Nancy Liu, The Interview, The Interview, Nancy Liu. Over to you.
Toastmaster and distinguished guests. Once upon a time, there was an interview conducted in an office. The interviewer, Mr. Roy, age 20, and the interviewee, Mr. V, age 50, both of them sitting on the table face to face. Mr. Roy read at the profile of Mr. V. And started the questions. Mr. V, I knew you are the CEO for, many years, about 3 decades ago. But I'm wondering why you stopped working and looking for a job again. Then Mr. V, look at Mr. Roy. Silent for a moment, and the eyes started to wave, and said, Mr. Roy, listen to me. It's not that I cannot find the penis here. Can you say that? But let me share with you, Mr. Roy, a story. About 20 years ago, I got a heart attack. And I consulted a doctor, and the doctor asked me to get a rest, suggest that maybe to take a long trip to anywhere of the place, just out of the office. So, Mr. Roy, I follow the doctor's advice. You know where I went? I went to a farm, which I think that place can give me more relaxation. So, I did. I went to the farm the first day. Wow, I really like those kind of relaxed environments. I can get away from all these busy people like I'm working in the office. But Mr. Roy, when the day I stay there and I become very bored because I got nothing to do and I just sat there, I started to think of my work again. So consult the farmer to give me some job. Mr. Farmer, please give me something to do. So the farmer said, all right, don't worry. Thank you for helping me. So the farmer asked Mr. V to go and clean the cow shit. Mr. Farmer thought, Lucy, also what? I asked you to clean shit, now you do it all. So Mr. V, follow the advice, okay? Clean sheet, no worry. Smelly, okay, I do. Then half a day, Mr. V already finished off the job. So the farmer surprised, not bad. Then the second day, Mr. V came to Mr. Farmer again. He said, I have got no work again. Please give me some job. And then this time, Mr. Farmer said, all right, why not you try to chop the chicken, only the chicken head, yeah? But not only one, not only two, but 500 chicken head, you know? Mr. V said, okay, chicken head, I do. Good job, head. So by the end of the day, Mr. V completed the chopping task. Then the farmer said, this CEO, not bad. Well, then the third day, the farmer offered another job for him. Went to Mr. V and said, okay, Mr. V, now this time, why not you try to help me to divide the potato into 2 boxes. Now, this box filled with a small potato and the other box, the big potatoes. All right, Mr. V followed and then sat there staring. This time, very weird, can't do anything. Then the job is not completed. So Mr. Farmer came and looked at it. Hey, box is empty. So he curious and asked, Mr. V, you had been doing two difficult jobs in the first day and second day. But how come today, both boxes are empty? Then Mr. Lee said, you know, Mr. Farmers, you listen to me. In my life, I am cutting head and clear all the shit, you know, in my office.
Now,
I think now you ask me to do this simple job. It's about making decisions. I think it might make my heart attack more serious. Fine. So Mr. Lee turned to Mr. Roy, the interviewer again. Now, you entertain me in this situation. Actually, I'm not a bad person, you know. I'm a good person. Because in my office, I do take care of my people. I remember one time, I invited all my executives to my house. I think during Chinese New Year. So I invited them to my house and took them a tour in my house. There was one big swimming pool there. So suddenly I got an idea and I told them, I said, okay, everyone, listen to me. All of you are good leader. You will not want to become a good leader, you must be measured by courage. So this is your chance to show me. Whoever can jump into the pool and then swim across to the end, I will give you everything. My money, my job, anything. But ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Roy, do you know in the swimming pool, there are many alligators there. So the team of executives laugh at each other, but suddenly there is a big splash. It's one of the executives went into the pool, and then the executive turned and looked at the executive. The executive, by the way, is the CFO, the chief financial officer. And then he saw him swim across, you know, the swimming pool, and then can swim in between. The alligator was so brave. And then at the end, he got up. So this CEO, Mr. Lee, very surprised and looked at him. Wow, you're so brave. Now I make my promise. Yes, you can get everything from me, my money, everything. But tell me, how can I help you further? Then this CFO said, You know, Mr. Lee, I want to know who the hell that pushed me into the pool. So Mr. Roy, even though I'm 50, but I'm happy to work in the office.